Now, hemifacial spasm is a form of muscle spasm, so in that effect, the symptoms are just like dystonia. But it does what it says. You get spasms affecting the muscles of one side of the face. And typically what would happen, people notice some twitching around the eye. Sometimes you can get spasms, so that eye closes. And often at the same time, these brief spasms will be associated with twitching or pulling of the muscles of the cheek and the corner of the mouth on that side. In other words, hemifacial. So the symptoms are very similar to dystonia. It's not classified as a dystonia because it has a different cause from all the other forms. Most forms of dystonia are due to a circuit problem affecting the circuits in the brain which control movement, so it's a brain disorder. In hemifacial spasm, it's actually a disorder of the muscle, of the nerve that supplies the muscles of the face. So the facial nerve, which runs from the base of the brain to all the muscles on each side of the face, is a nerve, and just like any other nerves, it's like an electrical household wire, and it passes an electrical message to the muscles to make them contract. In hemifacial spasm, it does that out of control, so it keeps firing out of control, and each time it fires, it produces a spasm on the face. In some cases, there's no reason, but in many of the cases, it's due to pressure on that nerve, often from a very small blood vessel which presses on it in the base of the brain, and that's what triggers off the firing of this facial nerve. So it can be considered a type of dystonia, but if you use the actual formal classification, it's not. It's actually a peripheral nerve problem. The treatment, however, is very similar to dystonia, and most people get good effective relief from botulinum toxin injections, which partially weaken those overactive muscles around the eye and in the face, and it reduces the spasms until the toxin wears off, and then you repeat it. And most people manage on that. If you've got hemifacial spasm, most often it's investigated by having an MRI scan of the brain, particularly to look at the base of the brain where the facial nerve runs, to see is there anything pressing on it. And the most common finding, if that's the case, is a small blood vessel. And in those cases, there is a neurosurgical operation which can be curative. The base of the skull is opened and the nerve is found, and they find where the blood vessel is pressing on it. And basically, all the surgeon does is put a little bit of sponge-like material between the blood vessel and the nerve to take the pressure off of the nerve, and that can be curative. Occasionally, other factors can cause pressure on the nerve. It can sometimes be due to trauma. Occasionally, a benign tumor can be found. But in most cases, you either find the blood vessel or you find nothing. If it's nothing, the best treatment is usually with botulinum toxin. If there's a blood vessel, it's worth considering what's called microvascular decompression operation. It's not as common as the other forms of dystonia, but interestingly, like a lot of focal dystonias, hemifacial spasm is more common in women. And the best guesses are that for women, about 14 out of every 100,000 women get hemifacial spasm. And for men, it's about 7 out of every 100,000. So it's about twice as common in women. And again, that has some similarities with the focal dystonia. So cervical dystonia is more common in women to men, sometimes felt to be 3 times more common. Blepharospasm and some of the other facial dystonias are more common in women than men. But strangely, and again, for reasons we don't understand, focal dystonias affecting the hands and the arms, such as writer's cramp, are more common than men than women. So there's something about gender or sex that affects dystonias and indeed hemifacial spasm, but we really don't understand why that comes about.